first time this century Scotland have made it. You look quite teary yourself.
Oh, it's emotional. I mean, I'll tell you right now. But do you know something? It would have been a travesty had we not made it. Sit and watch the entire 120 minutes, particularly for the 90 minutes, Mark. It was as good a performance as I've seen from Scotland in years. Years. I honestly don't think the kind of highlights did it justice there. We were excellent from start to finish, switched off in the 90th minute, and all of a sudden we'll go through the agony of extra time and penalties. I am absolutely thrilled. I'm thrilled for everybody, but I'm really, really pleased for the players and the boys, because there's been a generation of great players haven't made it. You know, Darren Fletcher and Barry Ferguson, Scott Brown, boys like that. These lads have made it. I'm so pleased for them because they've got an opportunity to play in a major tournament. Magical.
And it's amazing to hear David Marshall saying that the referee and the assistant told him, don't celebrate too early if you save one, because we need to adjudge and make sure that at least one of your feet is on the line. And you can see there, Lee, we can see that circling there. Goalkeepers are doing that a little bit now, aren't they? They're almost starting behind the line because they know they're going to come forward a little bit, make sure that some of the foot is on the line.
Yeah, absolutely. And he was just double-checking. And I mean, his face when he finds out that his players had already caught him up and he was there ready to celebrate. So, and I had to catch up on the highlights because I was doing the commentary, but I needn't have bothered because Ali ran me through every single kick.
I think you could hear him from up there, couldn't you? I think the England players were turning around at one stage going, what's going on in the bowels of Wembley?
It's brilliant. It's brilliant for the fans and the players and Ali.
Yeah.
To be fair, as Ali said, Dykes, Christie and McGinn were absolutely outstanding. Such a difficult front three to combine, and Serbia struggled, really struggled to cope with them.
Yeah, because we felt going to Serbia was going to be very hard for Scotland. We know how technically good they are. Yeah. You know, in that part of the world, let's be blunt, aren't they? Technically extremely good, very skillful. So you'd have felt going into it that Serbia would have the edge.
No doubt about it, Mark. They started the game as favourites, but going back to the previous tie, I actually preferred to play Serbia than I did Norway. I thought big Haaland might have caused us some serious problems. So as difficult a tie as it was, and we were still second favourites going into the game, it was the better of the options for me. But I didn't envisage us playing so well for the entire 90 minutes. I've got to be honest with you. They were poor. They've got to say they were poor, but we were absolutely excellent, you know, to a man. And Iain touched on it. Here's a goal from Christie, who was superb. McGregor makes a brilliant run across the face and gives him the half yard to come back onto his left foot. And it's, I've got to say, I haven't cheered a goal for a link-up play from two Celtic players as much in a long, long time.
Ever.
Absolutely. I mean ever. I don't mean a long time. No. I mean ever, Mark. And at that time, you know, it wasn't against the run of play. We actually deserved it. And on form, touched on it. I thought Dykes, for the first time in a long time, we've got a focal point up front, somebody that can get us up the park. He'll get his free kicks, he'll win his headers, and McGinn get around about him. Christie looks comfortable on the ball. McGregor looks, Jack, look, they all look comfortable on the ball. And, as you can probably see, thrilled.
The joy of football will always be in the nature of the scoring system. However good Scotland were, they couldn't get the second, and you were going through all of it. Oh. And then when Serbia got that corner in the last moment, does everybody get sucked a bit towards Mitrovic because he's such a threat?
That's what happens exactly, man. It's a great delivery, and Milodinovic puts a lovely ball in, and Jovic just peels. He doesn't, it's not a lot of movement, he just gets half a yard. Look, they're too keen. McTominay's keen on, I think it's Mitrovic, he just takes a half a yard step behind him. And that's all he needs. And I've got to say, he was a danger when he came on. He a couple of headers at the near post as well, and he was a threat. But, you know, that was... And I just thought when that went in, I thought, lads, you know, it was a real blow. It was a real blow, but, you know, it didn't affect him. We were under the cosh a little bit, extra time. But to come back and go through, you know, previous teams might have crumbled.
It affected you, Ali. You're on your knees.
It affected me.
I mean, I had to lift you up off your knees, to be fair.
I was.
And by the way, you're a bit heavier than I thought.
The nation deserved to know I was on my knees at that point.
You were on your knees.
I was on my knees at that point because I was gutted. That's football.